you think that you ain't worthy, I'm not capable, God, I just can't do it. Then you start getting all anxious. You know how it is when you know that you ain't got no money and the bills due, and you start getting real anxious because you don't know what's going to happen. That's fear. A lot of people live in fear every day. Every day. Only fear God wants you to have is the fear to reverence Him. That's the only fear. If anybody here fearful of another person, baby, you need to get some help. No, seriously, I'm serious, because you should not live in fear of human flesh or even your own mind.
Right.
That mind got to be unlocked.
Jesus.
I've seen people live in fear until in fear literally tormented them. And they, do you know fear will bring on health, bad health,
yes,
tumors?
Yes.
Why do you think heart failures? Because people live in fear. Not knowing what's going to happen. Or some of us can't live in our existing world. I tell people, if you got in it, God is able to bring you out. But you got to be willing to do something to come out. One thing I tell people, you want your life to change, but you're not willing to change. God, please help me tonight. You're not willing to do anything to make your life be different. God, I just want you to wave along. It doesn't work like that. You're going to find out tonight through this lady Rahab that she did something.
Well.
And she was not afraid, because she said, sink or swim. I know that this God is real. That's the thing. If you don't believe God is real, I want to let you know, ladies and gentlemen, sisters and brothers, you will never get what God got for you. Because when you believe that it's real, you reverence Him. You're afraid to do anything, treat anybody in any kind of way, go anywhere you want to go, do what you want to do. You are fearful of it. Because you know that it's a God that watches you, not sometimes, Sister Shea, to share 24/7, even when you sleep. Yeah, people say, well, I go around the corner and whisper. Do you know God hears a whisper?
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people, those whispers got them in trouble. Psalms 1:11-10. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. A good understanding have all they that do His commandments. I want you to look at that word in only two letters. Do. Do. His commandments. Not my commandments. God's commandments. His praises endure forever.
Amen.
I want to let you know, when you do God's commandments, is nothing that God won't do. When you do what He tells you to do. The thing you want to find out today, you got to do exactly what God said do. You cannot take shortcuts. I tell people that all the time. You cannot take shortcuts. No matter how hard it gets, you got to do exactly what God tells you to do. It doesn't matter how you feel. God, help me tonight, Holy Ghost, because you're not going to feel it all the time, but you still got to do it. Why? Because God said so. You know how we always say, well, why? I ain't got to do that. No, you don't have to do it. But I want to let you know, you have a God you got to answer to. You ain't got to do nothing. Like Burger King say, have it your way. But the way you have it is the way you got to keep it. It surprises me when people make a mess out their life and then they're going to blame it on the devil. Don't blame it on the devil. You have a will, and you will to do that. Now you got a will to come out of it if you want to.
Right.
I told you, only one person He wants you to fear, and that's Him. And that's with a reverence. Not going around, oh, I can't do nothing because I'm scared God's going to kill me. No. He don't like that kind of fear. He wants the fear where you honor and do His will. with yourself. You did stuff, bought stuff that you didn't ask God, can I have? Is this your will for me? And how many of you can pay with a big price tag when you don't ask God? Oh,
Jesus.
Been there and done that. Here in Joshua the second.